Oh my god. It has been too long. A good 3 months or so since I last, since I did the last live stream on Skylanders. Hey guys, how's it going? Marcelo here. We're almost ready to get started. I just need to, bring up the live stream on, my iPod and on the computer, and we'll get started in a bit.
Hold up. Oh my god, you can probably hear my cat meowing in the background. Okay, shit. I gotta move some stuff around real quick. Let's see, let's move the Wii U back here. Okay, sorry if you guys can hear this, but we're gonna move this back there. I need some room so I can put a chair here. Should I go with my squeaky ass office chair or my comfortable yet very low hanging blue beanbag chair? Well, seeing as my me is blue and the background's blue, I guess we'll just go with a blue theme. I have to move all this shit. Also, I saw you guys in the chat. Hey, what's up? See, it was Frederick and Roy, I believe. Yep. Is this the first time you guys are seeing my me? I'm not sure. It might not be, but, also, I sound like shit, because I'm still, like, getting out of being sick. Oh my god, this is just so cute. That's my mom in the background. Where the hell? Okay, now I have to bring up the live stream on my iPod. Where is it? Alright, hold up. Oh, I'm gonna bring the chair over here. Oof. Okay. Oh man, this is really low. Alright, let's... Sorry guys, let me adjust the mic. Okay. If you guys have a pet peeve for, stuffy voices... Sorry. So, I initially promised 2 live streams, but I figured, well... I'll just do the Crash 100% live stream next Sunday when I'm like actually really feeling better. Okay, I can't find the damn thing. Destination mark live stream. Okay, let's type in Crash live stream. Crash live stream. There we go. I already put out a call on Twitter, too, so hopefully you guys can spread that around, being like, hey, he's streaming again for the first time in 3 months. That's the first time Roy's seen my me. Frederick also says, I think it's the first time I've seen your me, too. Yeah, Frederick can't stay for too long, because school is tomorrow. Well, work is tomorrow for me, too.
So I can only be up until 7. We're not going to go until 7. I'm just saying, like, we're only going to talk for a few hours, maybe 2, 2.5. If it even lasts that long. It depends on just how much we feel we've covered. Am I going to be playing anything? No, I already said that. Initially, I was. What we're doing right here, the reason why the Wii U's on is because we're going to be watching footage. Footage we've already seen, but I just want to watch it, analyze it with you guys, cover, what we're seeing and what's being shown, and we're just talking about it. Really. Initially, I was going to do 2 streams today, both this one and I was going to 100% Crash 1, but since I'm just still coming out of being sick, and you can totally hear it in my voice, I'm going to save the Crash 1 live stream for next Sunday. Also, let me just turn down the volume on my computer real quick so I can hear myself talking with my headphones, and I'm not even wearing my headphones.
I only know that because the...
You can hear my peeps talking in the background, as per usual. Alright. Oh, look. We've got Crash Bandicoot himself in the live stream. How's it going? He says... Oh, wait. Well, there's a bunch of people coming in. Hold on. Sonic Mutant Show is in the stream. Sinir Mist... I don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, is in the stream. As I said before, simply going by Crash Bandicoot is in the stream. Nice. Okay. So let's see. He says, quick question. If there were to be a CTR remastered DLC, what would you want? What would you want, and how could we make Activision do it? Well, the funny thing is that if you've seen, which we can totally watch later if you want to. Oh, hi, what's up?
Washing machine is done.
Okay. Let me see. If you guys want, we can later watch this. The coverage at PSX after the conferences and all that ended. Actually, it was day 2 of PSX. A couple of the guys from Vicarious Visions went over some stuff. It wasn't stuff we didn't already know, but... Someone brought up, or at one point they brought up, oh, what about, some fans have been wanting a CTR, remastered, and they were just kind of like, I don't know. So, like, it doesn't exactly mean no, but they're not going to just jump into saying, yes, we're going to do CTR remastered. Like, they're not going to just jump right in with that. So, I don't know. I don't think it would be, like, any kind of DLC to N-Sane Trilogy. I would think if they were going to do that, it would be its own standalone thing. But I don't know. It's way too early to say, like, oh, at some point they might want to do it. I don't know. They were kind of being a little coy with it, like, oh, I don't know. But it's kind of a tease, but I wouldn't really call it a tease. Like, it's a tease unlike the teases that we've gotten for Crash coming back in general. Like, those were legit teases. Like, hey, guys, remember Crash? Like... Those were legit teases. Them not outright denying or deconfirming that they would do it. I think they're just leaving it open for, once these remasters come out. And it's all about seeing how they do. So, that's what I think. Completing Crash 100% is like trying to beat Rayman 1. It's really funny how everyone says that beating Crash 1 100% is hard. Okay, well, maybe for me it's not as hard because I just play that game all the freaking time. When you guys see it in the live stream next week, there will be some moments where I'm just going to fuck up royally. But it's not that hard. I guess I'm not the right guy to really come to when it's like, hey, how hard is it to, or whatever, to beat Crash? Because to me it's not hard, because I've played this game so many times. I pretty much know it front to back. It's just that there are still... That being said, that doesn't mean I'm perfect at the game. I'm still going to fuck up, and you're going to totally see that. It's not the hardest for me, because I know what to do, it's just the act of doing it is what makes it hard. Because there's a couple levels, like, Slippery Climb is no longer really one of the hardest levels for me to, you know, beat. Cortex Power and Fumbling in the Dark are the ones that piss me off the most. Those two really get me. So, you'll totally see that, in the live stream. Okay, enough jibber jabber. Let's get started. Crash Bandicoot N-Sane Trilogy. No actual specific release date, besides it's coming out obviously next year. I'm so fucking hyped. This is everything I wanted. This is everything a lot of us wanted. Let's start with what else. The first thing we saw when they announced this. The comeback trailer. Alright, let's get started. Let's watch this. Let's just stop on that image real quick. God damn, I am ready for this. Okay, so that was the first thing that they showed us, that they showed off at PSX. And God, it looks fucking gorgeous. There are a few things I want to highlight here, or at least a few things I want to kind of go in. Now, I haven't done this yet. I don't know why I haven't done this yet. I guess we'll do it together. I wanted to go and look at a couple parts, here, hold on. Let's find, oh, geez. Okay, let's watch it through one more time. I'm gonna stop at certain points. I want to see more of those levels. They've only showed off in the demo, Insanity Beach and Heavy Machinery. So I want to stop and see what, the other levels look like, just from the quick glimpses and flashes we get. Okay, so like here, for example, here's Temple Ruins, and wow, it looks really good. It's a different palette. It's not, you know, green like you just saw, but damn, it looks really good. Not a whole lot to talk about, really, to be honest, for this one. Except that you can see more of... It's not as scary, I guess. Because you can definitely see more of your surroundings. It's not just pitch black. And that's pretty cool, I guess. Damn, it looks really good. Let's see. What else we got here? You can see the fire in the background. Boulders looks really good. We got Papu Papu's fight. Damn. Oh, I like the redone. The boss meter looks really cool. And his redone little, icon. Here, let me see what you guys are saying real quick. Did I see Hogwild? Yeah, we'll get to that in a minute. Let's see. Someone asked a question down here. Roy asks, should Crash Bash get a remake? It'd be cool to see it, but I'm not, like, exactly hyped for one. If one never really happened, I wouldn't really exactly mind. I wouldn't be upset. But it'd be cool if it got, remade. Frederick says, I love the goofy expressions that Crash has in this trailer. Yeah, it's very, very, it's just very reminiscent of the first game. It's really cool. Crash says, you don't know how many times I've watched the gameplay. Yeah, same here, bro. We're gonna get to the B-roll footage, we're gonna get to the intro, we're gonna watch all that stuff. And, we'll even read a blog post, real quick, from Vicarious Visions, themselves. So we can really, if you guys haven't seen it or read it, they really go into detail of what they are trying to accomplish with this. And I love reading what they have to say, because you can tell they really care about, you know, getting this right. So, let's see, there's something I wanted to mention, too. Oh, yeah, so apparently, I don't know, like, if this is exactly true. There are some key differences, in certain, like, visually in certain parts. I don't think I can bring it up, on here. But some people have noticed that between the demo footage and the B-roll footage, and even certain points in this footage from the trailer, I think those were all taken from different points in development. The reason why I said I don't know if I can bring it up, but I mean by it, is there was this side-by-side comparison that someone made of one part of the Tana bonus round that they showed off in the B-roll footage, and that someone was playing for the demo. And there's some, like, visual little differences here and there you can actually see, and it looks really cool. It's cool to point out the little differences, but it makes you wonder, like, wow, so they just took from different points of development and put it all together. So I thought that was pretty funny. And you can really see how, like, some of the gameplay looks kind of slow in this trailer. Like, Crash seems to move a little slowly. But when you watch, like, the B-roll and you watch the people play the demo, it seems to just flow really nice and very natural, a little more normal, as it were. Very similar to the original game, so that's pretty cool. Oh, let me see. Oh, Mr. Luigi Gamer, what's up? You want me to show those differences? I'll try and find it. I don't remember who put it up. I think I saw it on Twitter, I think. Let me see. Crash Bandicoot. N-Sane Trilogy. I don't even know what to type in to search for it. If I type in comparison, it's just going to show stuff that's comparing this to the original game. How should I look it up? Shit. N-Sane Trilogy. Okay, we'll get to that. Hold on. Let's do one thing at a time. I'll show it off later. I have to find it first. So, okay, we got this. Papu looks badass. This entire area. I also wanted to mention, so, the light, everyone's not complaining, but taking specific note of the lighting in what we've seen from the trailer and all that. Because it seems to be, like, the same time of day and all that for, you know... Well, it makes sense. Now that I'm thinking about it in hindsight, it makes sense for all the lighting in the first island levels to look the same. Because if you really look at how the day-to-night progression, I guess you could say, happens in the original Crash game, it starts off day, you know, when you're on Insanity Beach. And then it just goes from... You know, when you get down the road, you know, to, like, the Lost City, it's, like, afternoon, and then you keep going, and eventually, like, I think Slippery Climb is at night, you know, during a stormy night, so there's some good progression there with, you know, the time of day and the lighting that, you know, would that you would have on those times of day. We did see, and I'll stop on it right now, we did see some quick footage of one of those levels. It's either Sunset Vista or the Lost City, and it looks to be about that same time of day as, you know, N-Sane Beach or, you know, something. So they haven't nailed down the lighting just yet. I'm assuming they're going to change that. I kind of hope they do. Just that way they can really capture, like, the whole time of day thing and see, even, like, you know, upstream and all that. It all has the same lighting. You just have to have a good eye for it. Oh, whoa, there we go. Hogwild, hold on. Let's really look at Hogwild real quick. Ah, no, stop it. That's just my Wii U fucking up. Hold on. Ugh. Okay, here we go. Okay. First off, love the fucking little spike pillars. Looking very reminiscent of the ones in the original game. We just get quick glimpses. You can't see much there. There's upstream. Yeah, see? Oh, well, no, they did kind of get it down, I guess. It just looked weird. I wonder which level that is. Since, you know, a lot of these share the same themes. It could be either or. You never really know. So it does look afternoonish, but I think they just need to, like, really fix it. Or, I wouldn't say fix it, but tweak it, you know? It looks afternoonish, I guess. I hope that they kept out the whole red sky. It looks very, you know, afternoonish. I mean, I don't know how else to describe it. I don't know. What are you guys thinking about this? Let's see. Let's find something else. We're almost at the end of the trailer. Oh, let's see those bats real quick. Oh my god, look at their faces. Ha! That's great. Also, I love how the bouncy crates have the Wumpa fruit inside of them. Here's the thing, though. If you guys didn't know this, if you really, really look at the bouncy crates, I'm not sure if this goes across all of them, the bouncy crates in all of the original three games, but at least in this one, in the first game, if you really look at the texture of the face of the bouncy crate, you can see Wumpa Fruit in the box. So I thought that was a new feature, but it's not. Apparently it's not. I had no clue that was a thing. Although, funny enough, I remember seeing that texture, the face of, you know, the front part of the bouncy crates, and it always looked funky. Like, there was always, like, this weird, I don't know how to describe it. I looked at the front of the bouncy crates, and it looked very, the colors looked weird, but I didn't think anything of it until, like, I really, someone else on Twitter was like, oh my god, you can actually see the Wumpa Fruit in the crates even back in the first game. And I was like, what? So I looked, I'm like, oh my god, you can. So that's pretty cool. But those bats look really funny. So this is once again either Temple Ruins or Fumbling in the Dark. Probably Temple Ruins. I mean, again, you never know because they both have these kinds of segments. So it's hard to tell. But let me see. I'm looking at this. So this is, it's a very more brown tone than the green tone that we've got in the original game. I wonder why they decided to change the palette. We got those guys. Here, hold on. Let's see Toxic Waste real quick. Oh, look at those guys. Oh my god. Dude, Toxic Waste. Everything's just green. Because of the Toxic Waste. That's funny. Damn, look at that. Oh, and one piece of detail. It's really cool. One piece of detail that they put here. I'm not sure, not every single enemy. I'm not sure, I'm not even sure if it's with this enemy in particular. It's only, like, you know, specific to this guy. But in the original game, when you spin him, as, you know, they do right here, this particular dude spins around, and he does this exact same thing right here. Whee! So that was pretty cool. Oh, shit, hold on. Stop it. Okay, let's see. Where is it? Ah, it goes by so fast. Fucking cortex power. Just talking about that. Stop it. Stop it! Jesus. It goes by so fast. Let's see if I can do it. That's a great... That's funny. Damn, look at that. Okay, so that's cortex power. We can't see a whole lot of what's going on, per se. That's pretty funny right there, though, just the way Crash looks. Oh, the fucking little electricity things. That's right. It looks really good, though, so far. Yeah, the Crash dance is back. He goes, toxic waste looks sick. Yep. Oh, CS Tex is in here. What's up? Let's see, I'm just going through everyone's comments in the chat. They filmed that at a weird angle, so it's hard to say with the lighting. Yeah. Yeah, everyone's talking about how in certain levels we can't tell if it's Sunset Vista or Lost City. Is it Temple Ruins or is it Jaws of Darkness? Is it Jungle Rollers or is it, you know, the Rolling Stones? So, let's see. What else we got here? Okay, just the same stuff. Damn. Alright. So, yeah, okay. I have to look up that one thing, later. So there's that. The trailer is freaking amazing. I think they did a really good job with it. yeah. So, okay, so, thoughts. Throw out some thoughts there. I really wish I could put the fucking chat, overlay the chat in the actual live stream so people can see it. Because now we're just staring at a black screen and it's awkward. So, throw out some thoughts. What do you guys think of the comeback trailer? That's what I love that they called it that. The comeback trailer. Also, CrashBandicoot.com is back and up and running, which I thought was really cool. Oh shit! Come on. God, I hate that I'm stuffed up. I hate being stuffed up. Mr. Luigi Gamer says it looks nice as hell. Here, let me see. People are saying things. People are saying things. What is happening? Okay, let's see. Let's go through people's stuff. Sonic. I'm just gonna call you Sonic for short. Says that he wants Crash Team Racing and Crash Bash remastered together as a PlayStation exclusive. Again, I wouldn't be opposed to it. If they never did it though, like, I wouldn't really, you know, be upset over it. Well, that's just me though, so. Let's see. Mr. Luigi Gamer wants to send me a link. Depending on what it's 4? Like, is it a video or is it like... What is going... Oh. What are you doing? What's up? What's up? Oh. Okay, go on.
Your washing machine is done.
I know. Go on. The hell was I saying? Is the link a video or is it something else? If you can send it through the chat, that'd be cool. And then I can check it out, in a little bit. Let's see. Frederick says, Crash's model gave me Wrath of Cortex vibes at first. Are we talking like the Xbox version with the fur? And people still say that the fur is weird. I'm like, no, it's not really. It could have been worse. It could have been like Conquer Live and Reloaded levels of just fluffy as shit. They made Crash fluffy as shit, and thank God, because that would have looked awkward. I think it's the right level of, like, you know, detail. Because his fur in Skylanders is, like, it's very patchy and very, like, blocky, because that's just Skylanders' art style. I didn't hate it. I was like, okay, well, you know, he looks detailed. This is the first time we're seeing, like, a super detailed Crash in a game. So that's awesome. And that version of Crash is just, like, an amalgamation of, like, what their own original design plus what they just took from, you know, concept art and stuff like that. But, no, this legit right here is Crash 1 Crash. Just more detailed. And that's exactly what I wanted. Seeing as it's a remaster plus, I'm like, okay, so with the character designs, it's something that you have to get right because people will start going apeshit over however they decide to do the character designs. So that was one of the things that I was always thinking in my head. Like, if they ever remaster Crash 1, you know, that was before I knew that they were going to do all three. I'm just like, if they ever remastered Crash... And, you know, they did something that was going to keep to the classics. They can bring back his classic design and just make it look highly detailed. That's exactly what they did here, so I'm super grateful for that. I'm like, okay, they didn't fuck anything up. It all looks good right now. It looks amazing. Let's see. Oh, okay, so Mr. Luigi Gamer has, okay, let's see. I can't do it on my iPod. Let me go and try it on my computer. He sent some images. Let's see those images. Oh, and one video, so let's just see about that, too. Okay, well, I can't see the... Oh, wait, no, I'm stupid. Hold on. I'm getting lost in these comments. I have to find that one. Oh, shit. Shit. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. I was looking at images and stuff that Luigi Gamer sent me. I already saw this. With Aku Aku's comparison. I saw that. Okay, hold up. Okay, hold up. Let me come back over here. Oof. Okay. Yeah, I'll probably link that stuff down below in the description. Later after the live stream. I gotta remember to do that. Let's see. Frederick says the trailer looked awkward at first. He goes, but then I saw the B-roll footage and I started to like it more. The B-roll footage is awesome. We'll get to that in a minute. Yeah, I think they're going to space out the trailers for, you know, showing off these remasters. So that we've already seen Crash 1. We'll probably get more Crash 1 whenever they decide, hey, let's just put up a trailer. Here you go. And then we're like, oh, shit. Like, it comes out of nowhere. And we're like, oh, God. We have to react to this or whatever. You know, I'll probably make reaction videos the more trailers they show off regarding the first game, or once they finally reveal what the second game looks like. And then the third game, I'll be making reaction videos to all that stuff. It just, that goes without saying. So, yeah, let me read more comments. Oh, I'm freaking wondering what the ice. Oh God, the ice physics in Crash 2. Shit, I can only imagine how that's gonna work. Oh God. Now I just had freaking fucking PTSD flashbacks to that one fucking hard ass part. It's not for the it's Cold Hard Crash's gem. Oh shit. The get all the boxes gem. Oh fuck. That's one of the most difficult ones to do. Just because of all the shit you have to do to get it. And then the actual part that you the death route is fucking ugh. Jesus Christ. Just imagine that remastered. Oh, God. It's going to be crazy. Alright, Sonic Mutant. I'll see you later. He says bye. Oh, man. Yeah, it's going to be crazy. Let's see. Roy says, I don't see why they'd show more of Crash 1 other than to be nice. If it comes out in March, the next two trailers will probably just show off parts of the other games. Yeah. I was just saying, like, I'm not expecting them to show off more Crash 1, but if they did, as, like, a surprise, here it is, like, here's a little bit more showing off, like, some gameplay of a couple other levels or whatever else, if they just happened to do that, I'd be, like, all for it. But any other trailers that I am expecting, of course, are to show off Crash 2 and Crash 3, So, yeah, okay. So, oh, he also says, oh, damn, are you serious? The trilogy, trailer, is it the trailer? He says, Crash N-Sane Trilogy has, hit 1 million views, and it only took 2 days. Which, was it the trailer, though? The comeback trailer? It probably was. Roy says, the trailers will come out 1 month apart from each other, pretty much. Yeah, I can see that happening. I can totally see that happening. Wait. Let me see. Did I read? I already fucking, did I? Yeah, I already X'd out of the little tab for the comeback trailer. Shit. Okay, whatever. Let's watch the intro. Because the intro is fucking awesome. Alright. God, I love it. I love the way it looks. It looks so freaking good. So what do you guys think about the intro? I think it's awesome. There's some small changes, which I did go over in my second thoughts video. Because during my first thoughts video, that was still during PSX. So there was still a whole lot we hadn't seen yet. Although, that day as well, I believe it was still during the day of PSX. It was December 3rd. I went back eventually with Lysio and with G-Man Rocks to just find out anything else we could about the game and what we've been seeing. And we found Nukem Dukem, who was live streaming the game, the demo, at PSX. And G-Man goes, "Oh, dude, guys, scroll back to the beginning of the live stream." He shows off the intro. I'm like, "Whoa, what?" And that was our first glimpse at this, our first showing of the intro. And I was like, "Damn, it looks so good." I love that Tana kicks ass this time around, which is pretty cool. It's really hilarious. Just lays that dude out. It looks really good. The trailer hit 1 million views too? Are you serious? Mr. Luigi Gamer says, "Now I'm wondering about Coco." Yeah, I wonder if they're going to show her off in the second game. Because that's one thing that people are saying, like, well, if Tana's a badass now, and I talked about this briefly too in my second thoughts video, will they include her more in 2 and 3, like, in some way, shape, or form, besides an Easter egg, or will they just keep her an Easter egg in 2 and 3? I'm not really sure. Yeah, that's what Roy was just saying. One thing about the Crash remakes is that I hope Tana has more of a presence in 2 and 3, and they don't just push her to the side and forget about her like she's nothing in the original. I don't know. I don't really have much of a stance on it, because if they keep to the originals and they don't have her in 2 and 3, we're still getting Coco, we're still getting, you know, all the other villains, Tiny, Deagle Dial, Engine, and all of them. But now, the thing is, since she wasn't included in 2 and 3, if they do decide to include her in the remasters of 2 and 3, how will they do it? That's the thing. Because everything else that they've been showing us, they're sticking to the original. But then, when, you know, they go off and do something a little more original, like have Tana lay that Lamassison out, or, you know, just do something a little different, it's like, well, how would they do that? Well, the way they've shown us how they've done some of those different things so far, it looks really good. Now to go as so far as to include a whole character that wasn't even in 2 and 3 in there, how are they going to do that? What would she do, and what would her role be? Like, they can't just cut Coco out entirely, because she has whole levels dedicated to her in Warped. So how are they going to do that? But I don't really know. He says, Mr. Luigi Gamer says, "We need more animated cutscenes because, Lord Jesus, they're amazing." Yeah, I want to see the alternate ending when you go through the Great Hall. I want to see the ending in general when you beat Cortex. I want to see the visuals. I want to see the cutscenes of Cortex Strikes Back and Warped. I totally want to see all those. Okay, Roy says, Tana 1 doesn't have to be throughout the whole games. Just a small cameo or reference. Well, that's what they did in the originals. Well, I don't know about 2, but in 3, she's... there's a picture of her, like, on the wall or something. So those are small little, like, references. And they've always kept references, like, throughout the series, actually. Because I believe they have a picture of her in Wrath of Cortex, which is the same one, you know, in Warped. And then I think she was on, like, a sign or whatever, from that one part in Slump Slide Escapades and Twin Sanity. And then I think she was also a cameo in Mind Over Mutant at the very, very beginning in Crash's house. She's, like, on a poster or something. So I think that she looks different. It's a differently designed Bandicoot girl, but I think it's supposed to be Tana. Do I know about the Crash Bandicoot? Amino. Oh my god, I'm so stuffed up. Hold on. Oh man. The Amino. I can't even say that. I can't say my M's right now. What happened? I wasn't this stuffed up earlier. The Crash Bandicoot Amino. I think you're the one who told me about that in a comment on one of my other videos. I haven't seen it yet. But I have the Amino app. I haven't seen any crash related stuff on that app. Let's see. I saw something earlier. Oh, Roy says. Let's see. Hold on. I'm just reading more stuff. Okay. Roy says, I'd like for them to reference Coco in the first game in some way. All this to provide some sort of continuity to the series. Not a big deal, but it'd be a nice touch. Yeah, no, I can agree with you on that. Again, how would they do it? I don't really know. As a reference to, like, hey, she'll, you know, be around in the second game. I have no idea how they would do it, but if there's a way they could pull it off, that'd be cool. Let's see. Oh my god, I'm stuffed up. I hate it. Let's see. It'd be nice to have more physical, to see more physical appearances by Aftana. And, not pictures of her and stuff. well, hey, she was a playable character in Crash Boom Bang. I just remember that right now. Not that it really matters, because that game sucks ass, but... Oh, thanks. Frederick says he shared my fan film trailer on the Amino. Amino is, first off, what's up, J-Dog, 1337A. He asks what Amino is, and it's an app where it's very community-based. Like, there's just different communities. And you just go around. It's almost like a blog kind of thing, from what I gather. Because I have the app. I haven't really been on the app that much. But you just, you know, share stuff. You talk with other people about whatever it is. And that's really cool. So, Mr. Luigi Gamer and Frederick want me to join the Amino stuff. I probably will eventually. I might not have a lot of time to really, you know, do stuff. On it, but I'll see what I can do. Oh, thanks. He also shared my live stream. Yay. Alright, so, that was the intro. There's not much to stop and nitpick about or, you know, analyze, because it's very straightforward. Even, like, shot for shot, they try to make it look a lot like the original opening. So, there's not a lot to say. It's really cool. I like the changes they made. And it looks really cool. Let's go over the favorite part. My favorite part. The B-roll footage. God, I can't talk today. Why did I decide to do this? Why? Because originally I was going to delay both. Once I found out, shit, I'm sick. I was like, okay guys, I'm delaying both streams until next week. And then I started getting better. And I was like, okay, I think I have enough in me to be able to at least do one stream. And now for some reason, this did not happen at all at any point during the fucking day until now. My nose decides to be like, hey, Mark, guess what? Fuck you. And now I'm all stuffed up and it sounds like shit. I apologize profusely for that. But here comes my favorite part. My favorite piece of footage. The B-roll footage. He's like, please stop, no more. Dude, I fucking love it. I watched the B-roll footage, like, more than anything else that I've been seeing from the N-Sane Trilogy. It looks so fucking good. Okay, so you were wanting to see, I forget, what was it, Luigi Gamer? He wanted to see the thing I was talking about where there were differences. Now, I still can't find it, but let me show you, if you will. Let's see. So when you first start out, yeah. Oh, wow, look at Akoku. Okay, so when you first start out, as you can see on this first image, the only differences that were really prominent were, I believe they changed the, well, there's that, there's the big mushroom, little part that you start on. That's normal. Fuck, I can't talk. That is normal. The other little red one that's right there, that was not originally there. There was two of them, and they were purple. So, there is an image of it. I can't find it, though. And then they also, I think, changed. They didn't have that big-ass branch coming out right there on the top of that tree that you're on. I think they took that out, or something like that, because I remember that being a little different, too. But, yeah, that was the only thing, so, like, there's really no point to find it right now anyway, because, that was, like, the only major, difference you can see right off the bat, is that the one little red mushroom right there originally was actually two little purple mushrooms. That was, like, the only, and that was from the demo, I believe. Yeah, because seeing as this is the B-roll footage, the demo had, the two, things. Purple mushrooms. Is there anything else in here I wanted to go over? Oh, you can see that there's still some things they have to fix and tweak a little bit, as evidenced when they first, enter, heavy machinery. Whenever this decides to load, looks like it's flying. watch Akuaku. Yeah, see that they have to fix that, of course. And those are small things they left in because it wasn't the biggest issue with people. Oh god, Akuaku spawns the level backwards and then he turns around. Oh, and that means it's bad. Like, no, of course not. Get over yourself. But it's just a little thing they have to fix, you know. Stuff like that is fine to have around as long as you, of course, eventually fix it. There's something else I wanted to mention, too. I'm forgetting what it was. Let's just watch a little bit of it again real quick. Because there was definitely something else I was going to mention, and I forgot what it was. So let's just watch it over again. And I'm going to talk over it. Oh, come on, Wii U. Don't be a bitch. Don't be a bitch, Wii U. Come on. Okay, let's just scroll then. Also, the gamepad's about to fucking die. Ugh. Hold on, I'll be right back. I have to look at the charger. Are you still there? You don't have to use restroom? No, I'm not seeing it. Do you have a charger?
Huh? Oh, Mom.
The hamper?
Oh. Charger, right here. Oh yeah, I remember I was going to mention, but the fucking music is awesome. I still want to know who's composing for this damn remaster, because they're awesome. That was the one thing I was really fearing, in hindsight. I was like, shit, So if Josh Mansell himself confirmed that he's not going to have any part in the remasters, I'm like, well, there's a couple things they can do here. They can just take, he can provide, because he's been putting them up on his SoundCloud, he can just provide all of the pre-console mixes, since those were supposed to be the true versions of the songs from the original games. Because he's been posting for all three of them, of the games. He could provide those, I guess. Or they can get someone else to compose it, but if they did that, my thought initially before seeing all of this was, how are they going to make it sound, and how is it going to be? No, as we can, you know, see and hear for ourselves, it's fucking awesome. I really like the way the music is. I want to know who's composing. So, we need to find that out at some point. Let me see. There's a video on the differences? I didn't know that. Tell me who it's from, and I can probably search it up. Like, give me the title, and then, give me the title of the video, and then who it's from, and I can search it up. Instead of just sending me a link, because I'd have to go to my computer, put it in, see what it's all about, and then, like, put it up on here, which is a whole other thing. It's like, whatever. Frederick says, Vicarious Visions is pretty much the next Naughty Dog. Yeah. No, I wholeheartedly trust Vicarious Visions on this, because even before, like, we saw all of this, I was like, if not Naughty Dog, there's no one I would want more to, you know, completely remake these games or remaster these games from the ground up than Vicarious Visions, because they've had the most experience outside of Naughty Dog in handling the franchise. They've made so many games for the franchise that everyone really liked, you know. There wasn't really, I think the only Vicarious Visions game that for Crash that people didn't like was Crash Purple. But everyone loved the Game Boy games, the other Game Boy games, everyone loved Crash Nitro Kart, so it's like, yeah. Why wouldn't you get them to do the remasters? So I thought that was pretty cool. Let's see. Okay, so he posted the thing. Crash Bandicoot N-Sane Trilogy demo. No commentary. Does it show off, like, is it like a comparison of the differences, though? Because that's what I was trying to get at. Oh, he says it's not a difference video, but it shows the mushrooms and the little changes that I said. Yeah, okay, let's see. Crash N-Sane Trilogy. Oh. Demo. No commentary. Okay, I found it. Okay, let's see. If there are any other, like, differences, visual differences, I'm not sure. But the one that I know for sure, one of them that I do know for sure is, in the bonus room. I haven't seen this one before. This video of the gameplay from the demo. So I guess we'll just watch it from here. They just got everything right. I can't believe, like, this is what I personally wanted for Crash to come back in the modern age. Like, just, if you're gonna remake this game, just keep it the same for the most part. You can have your differences, but just make it look much more detailed. heavy machinery. Okay, so we'll eventually. Oh yeah, no, I already said it. The music is fucking kick-ass. Also, we'll see it eventually. The the vents in this level. In the original, they just go. He fell down into the secret. That's pretty funny. You're supposed to enter through. Okay. Oh, maybe I did see a little bit of this one. I don't remember. Yeah, you're supposed to fall down that little hole. Anyway, good job. What was I gonna say? So the vents in the original game just go push, push. But in this version, in the remastered version, you can actually see the vents open up and then they go push. So I let you know, oh shit, I have to move because they just opened. It's a subtle animation, but it's, again, great attention to detail. I love it. Which is almost at the end of the video. Yeah, let's just watch it, because why not? Jesus, can my brother laugh any louder? I also love the 3D life. The 1-Up icon. 3D life, that made no sense. A 3D 1-Up icon. Ha! I love it. I love that they carried over Crash 2 and 3 death animations into this one. It makes them all just, like, a little more cohesive, I guess. Yeah, see, look, you can see them opening up. Yeah, see, there we go. Two little purple, okay, so that big-ass branch is still there. But yeah, like I just said, the two purple mushrooms right there. So I wonder, if this is the final look, what they're going for. Because I believe that's how the original first game was, right? With those two purple mushrooms. I don't know. I don't remember exactly, like, those intricate little visual details from the first game. I'm just saying, like, I don't know. It was a weird little thought. Let's see. J-Dog says, you know, I imagine this could be the beginning of something great. First, Ratchet and Clank gets remastered. Now, Crash. How long till we get a Spyro remastered? Dude, I am waiting for Spyro to get something, fucking anything, that actually, you know, pays homage to his legacy. Nothing like this Skylanders bullshit that he's been going through. That is not Spyro. The hell's his name? Oh God. What the hell is his name? I can't believe I'm forgetting his name. I'll have to look it up. Hold on. Oh my God. Anyway, fucking hell. I'm trying to look up something. Hold on. Oh, yeah. Fucking wrong-ass name. Okay. How the hell did I forget Ted Price's name? Because I was gonna say, like, Ted Price is awesome, but how the hell does he think that they're treating Spyro right in Skylanders? Because they're not, in the slightest. Now, the cool thing is that he's never been opposed to coming back to Spyro. He just won't because he thinks that they're treating him right. But they're totally not. The thing is, if Skylanders ever actually dies off, will he then be like, oh, you know what, I think we should, you know, revisit Spyro. I hope that's what they do. And if not, give them to Vicarious Visions. Because they'll probably do something with them. So, that'd be cool. I definitely think that Spyro needs something. He needs something. Oh, J-Bill says, or not J-Bills, J-Dog says, I wonder what the bike levels will be like, the motorcycle levels. Oh, God. I hope they fix the control in those levels. Because turning in those levels is fucking, oh, jeez. It's blech. Yeah, a Luigi Gamer says that people were saying that the controls feel good. So, that's one thing I've been wondering, which has to go without saying, like, with the gameplay, how does the game actually feel to play? And people were saying, people who have been playing it were saying, yeah, it's good, it controls well. Because there's a distinct way that the first Crash game controls, the way Crash controls in the first game. That's different from 2 and 3. I wonder if they're going to stick true to that control scheme. Just the way he controls in that game. Or if they'll change it up a little bit. Just make it... All I'm expecting is for them to make it easy enough to control, I guess you could say. Speaking of Ratchet and Clank, one thing I remember saying when I talked about that game was... They made the control feel very, very fluid. The first Ratchet & Clank was a little blocky in some parts with the controls, but when I was playing the reboot, I was like, holy shit, they made the controls feel really good. Like, really good. So what I'm hoping, when we finally get to play N-Sane Trilogy, hopefully Crash just feels really good at control. And I'm wondering if they're going to keep those intricate little details. I wonder, now, speaking of intricate little details, control-wise now, I don't know if you guys have ever felt this yourselves or observed this yourselves. I mentioned this in the quick reviews video I did of Crash 3. In Crash 2, when you're jumping in midair, when you're in midair from when you jump, and you're holding down a direction to like jump somewhere from one, you know, like from a platform to another platform, or you're on a bouncing crate and you're jumping off the bouncing crate. When you're in the middle of your jump and you just stop, you know, the like hitting the when you let go of the button, whatever like directional button that you're pressing, he'll just stop in midair and he'll fall down. I mean he keeps his, you know, his distance, but he'll God, it's fucking hard to describe. I'd have to like fucking show you guys. When you're jumping, and you just stop the direction that you're jumping in, he'll just stop. In Crash 3 and in Crash 1, when you do that, the reason why people say that he's a little slippery with the controls is because something like that, where when you stop going in a when you're in midair and you stop hitting the directional button, he still kind of goes a little bit forward or whatever direction that you're going in. So, jumps aren't as accurate, I guess you could say, in Crash 1 and 3, but in Crash 2, you can get your jumps pretty dang accurate. If you want to just drop down somewhere, just stop hitting, you know, whatever control that you're hitting, whatever directional button you're pressing, he'll just stop in midair. It's a very, very hard thing to explain. You'd have to just see it for yourselves, or whatever, but, it's a very intricate piece of detail. That did make Crash 2 very fluid when you are jumping and doing stuff. I wonder if they're going to keep true to that, or if they're just going to make him control the same for the most part in all three games, and then just include his body slam and his slide in Crash 2 and Crash 3. Because as we can see right now, from what we've seen, he doesn't jump, he doesn't slide or belly flop in this one, which is, of course, true to the first game. And everyone keeps saying, well, why don't they have, like, the ability, like, what if they had the ability to unlock in this game? Like, when you beat the game or something, you can, like, unlock the ability to slide or belly flop. And I'm like, I wouldn't be all for that, because that just wasn't, he just couldn't do that in the first game. And it would take out a lot of the challenge in the way these levels were designed in the first game. It wouldn't be as challenging in a kind of a bad way. But those are just my thoughts. Like, I don't know. It'd be a little awkward to see him being able to do those abilities, to have those abilities that he just didn't have in that game, in this remastered first game. So I'm not really sure. Oh, Jables is here. What's up? 300 sub hype. Yeah, I hit 300 subs. Thank you guys. I still have to make that freaking... Oh, by the way, okay, so let me get that out of the way. Holy fuck, I can't talk. Okay, hold on. Let me get this out of the way. I was supposed to do a 200 subscriber special, which was a Q&A. And the Q&A is still happening. I'm just going to make it like a special event, like in general. Like, I guess I could do like a 300 subscriber special and have the Q&A be that. I had a few questions asked already, but you guys had from the 4th, when I first made the announcement, or the 5th, till Christmas. It was either the 24th or the 25th. So you guys still have a bunch of time. If you guys want to ask Q&A questions in the chat, go ahead, but preface it by saying, oh, hey, this is a Q&A question. So that way I don't answer it until the video. I make the video. So you can ask questions. I'll make a video about it eventually. You can ask the questions there when I make that video. You can ask questions here in the chat, but you have to say, oh, hey, this is a Q&A question. And then you can also ask them on my Twitter. And then just, you know, do that. So it's still happening, but it didn't happen for the 200 subscriber special. So since I can no longer do a 200 subscriber special, since I'm now at 300, I'll just have the Q&A be a 300 subscriber special. So I guess we'll do that. Let's see. Unbearable HD. Oh, God. No, I did say that at one point. I was like, imagine the freaking big-ass polar bear. Future Frenzy Remastered. That would be awesome. Future Frenzy Remastered would look really cool. Let's see. I'm just reading off. Yeah, Cortex's fights are going to be awesome. Of all the three Cortex fights from the three games, I really like the first one. It's an easy fight, but it's just really cool. The third game... Jesus Christ. My mom's watching football. The third game's fight is super fucking epic, so it's going to be really cool to see it in the remaster. Here, hold up. Let me be right back. I'm going to get some fucking water. Thank you.
also have to blow my nose, so I'll do that out of the room so you guys don't have to hear my nose blowing. I'll be right back again. Okay. I think we're good. Alright. Sorry. This is a shitty live stream. Okay. The Nat Kid is leaving. We will see you guys later. I'll see you later. Oh, shit. Fred Dick's going too? Alright, I'll see you later too, dude. Oh, let's see. Whoa, what's happening? What the fuck? I'm talking about a sacrifice or some shit. What's happening? Okay, that was weird. Okay, hold up. Let me save a Q&A. Question real quick. Okay. Oh, you were saying it might have someone else. I think it was Frederick. Yeah. Cool. Alright, see you later, dude. Okay, so what was I saying earlier? So I don't fucking remember. I'm gonna drink some water. Because my voice sounds like shit right now. I hate being sick. I had to call in sick from work as well, which was not good. Because I just started, like a few days ago. 4 days in, I already had my first fucking sick day. It's not a good reputation. Okay, so this is, we're gonna watch more gameplay. Okay, so this is the footage of this guy I tried to do. How do you miss? Also, Jess Harnell's, version of these voice clips is really fucking good. It didn't even sound like Jess Harnell, to be honest. Another piece of detail is, apparently, Akuaku's design on his crates is very, very Skylanders-based. The way he looks in Skylanders, kind of. That's what people have said. It does kind of look like that, so I thought that was pretty, it was cool as a way of, like, you know, there are some little bits and pieces of what they did in Skylanders in here. Such as the exact same spinning sound effect they use in Skylanders is, yeah, right there, see? The hell are you trying to do? God damn it, this guy. He's like, shit, let me try it again. Oh my god. I don't even know how bad I just want to be like, hey, give me that controller. I wanted so bad to go to Anaheim. Oh shit! Oh, this is actually new for me. Are we actually gonna get to see all of the Brio bonus round? Oh my god, dude. This guy, I'm sorry, this guy sucks. He's not gonna try it again? Oh my god! I was actually gonna shut up and just be like, oh shit, we're gonna see more about more of the Brio bonus round. Nope!
He took one jump, failed, and then didn't try it again. Idiot. How do you not try it again? How do you not have incentive to beat it? Oh my god, I'm actually mad now. I'm mad at this guy. Oh yeah, so speaking of things, I kind of want them to change too. I'm really hoping that they kind of change those from being little bouncers to like being the actual little push things from the first game. Because they still those as you're hearing right now just make that typical little boom boom kind of bouncy noise instead of like the little like push kind of pusher thing that it did in the original game. I don't know. I mean, I'm kind of just nitpicking when it comes to that. I don't really care so much if they don't change it. I'm just going to subconsciously, you know, internally, wish that they would. The Crash is like, I'm just dead. Yeah, I know, a public demo? No, hell yeah. That's what I want to see. Alright, so that's the end of that video. A public demo? God damn. He dribbles like this guy's trash. Ha! Yeah, that's hilarious. The Nat Kids is that, he goes, I think they had the opportunity to bring back the first voice actor, but they kept Harnell instead. Where the hell is Brendan O'Brien? Like, how have they... I'm surprised that they were even considering to get him, seeing as, like, he vanished from existence after recording all these, you know, because they've been using his voice clips well after he actually recorded all these lines and everything for these games. But he himself really didn't do much after the Crash games. So, like, who knows where the hell he went or what he's been doing, like, where he is right now, what he's been doing right now. Same thing goes for Mel Winkler. So I'm wondering if they're going to have... Because apparently from what I've heard, the redone Mudabaga, that apparently is fucking Greg Eagles. Doesn't sound at all like Greg Eagles, but I'm wondering if they're going to have him voice Aku Aku again in Warped. So I guess we'll have to see. But now the one thing I really do hope... it would be kind of cool. I don't know if they're going to do it, you know, after all, but I personally would like to see them bring back Clancy Brown as Uka Uka, because he's just a really good Uka Uka. Now apparently Lex Legg was Uka Uka in Skylanders, so if they have him voice Uka Uka, then that'd still be cool and funny in hindsight, seeing as we've got, you know, Crash 3 from back in 98. Clancy Brown was both Cortex and Uka Uka. Then all these years later, we've got a remastered version of Warped, and Lex Lang is both Cortex and Uka Uka. That'd be funny. But I would like to see Clancy Brown come back and do Uka Uka again, because he's going to sound the same, he'll have that same voice and everything, so... It would be really cool. That's my, like, what-if scenario. Like, what if they brought Clancy Brown back? But, I don't know. Haha! How the fuck do you miss 50 boxes? Yeah, Jesus. Everyone's been missing all the boxes. There's not a whole lot of footage floating around the internet of people getting the gems. There are, videos online of people getting the gems. But... Not a whole lot, to be honest. So it's pretty funny. It pisses me off. Okay, well now, Mega Bionic Man 3000 says that it's not Lex Lane voicing. Well, who the hell voiced Sukuga? Why could... You know what? Fuck this. We're going on IMDb. Because... I'm getting all kinds of shit from, like... Okay, we're doing this live. Look at this shit. Skylanders. Imaginators. IMDb. Okay, let me look this up. Let me just, you know, put it back to the little thing. Let's find out what's going on. Oh, we're already here. Okay, fuck it. Okay. Full cast. Now, apparently in here it says that, it's fucking, Alex Fernandez, who voiced Uka Uka originally in Twinsanity. Let's see. Just Hernandez crash. I saw Greg Eagles as Okwaku. Lex Lang as Dr. Neocortex. Okay. Well, shit. Okay, let's see. Yeah, see, Alex Fernandez as Uka Uka, uncredited. Was it really, though? God, why can't... Because it's not just... Oh, God. I don't even know what to think right now. Okay, so who was it? Was it Alex Fernandez or was it Lex Lang? Because I don't know. I don't know. And I honestly can't tell who it is. It's not obvious as to who it is. Whoever is doing the voice, the only thing I know that is clear by the performance of whoever is voicing Uka Uka in fucking Skylanders is that they do try to really bring in that Clancy Brownish feel. So, what?
Do you want something?
Are you going across, to Shell?
Yeah, I'm going
there.
Often.
Yeah. Alright. That's another one of those typical my brother's going, to the store dealios that happened in another live stream. Shit, my voice is getting all weird again. My nose is getting stuffed up. Okay, so fucking, I don't know who's voicing Uka Uka. Sorry it got all loud. I don't give a fuck. Alex Fernandez was a pretty okay-ish Uka Uka in Twin Sanity. He was okay. He was pretty funny. I don't know. I don't fucking know. Let's see. What are people saying? Let's see. What the fuck is happening? Okay, we're doing it live. Yeah. For me, showing IMDb. Okay. J-Dog's like, as I'm watching this live stream about a happy children's game, I'm doing a blind run of Resident Evil 4. Let's see. What's happening? Okay. That kid says, I think they should get an actual native person to voice Okwaku. The same goes to Crash being voiced by an actual Australian person if he talks, but in a loony way. Well, he did have an Australian accent in Skylanders Academy. Not a whole lot of people seem to like it. I thought it was okay. I don't know why they didn't just bring Okwaku into the show along with Crash. Because then you could just keep Crash silent and have Okwaku do all the talking. That could have led to some funny stuff, I guess. While we're here, let's just look at who's been voicing who here. Because I haven't really taken the time to really see. So I just saw Hidden Walsh is here as Chop Scotch. I don't remember who that is. Let's see, who else is in this? Yeah, it's funny, because if you look back at, there's another guy. Oh, fucking Xander Mobus is in this. I had no clue he was in this game. Xander Mobus is the announcer for Smash 4. So that was pretty cool. Lex Lang is Cortex. We just saw that. Yeah, Flipwreck. Just Harnell's Flipwreck. I'm guessing that's the dude from... There's this one part of the game where you're trying to build Let's see if I'm remembering this right. You have to build these robot dudes, and that's your mission from this one level. And there's one of these little NPCs you talk to, and it just... The minute I heard him talk, I was like, that's Jess Harnell. That is Jess Harnell. Because I've really come down to recognize his voice, where I could just pick him out of, like, whatever. If it's not, like, a voice that doesn't sound like him at all, there's enough to where I could be like, oh, I recognize that as Jess Harnell. So I heard this dude talk, and I'm like, shit. I just picked it up easily. Like, super fast. There's a Jennifer Hill. They didn't even credit who she voices. Let's see. Chris Quox. There's Glumshinks. Laura Bailey. There's Persephone. Wasn't Tara Strong Persephone in, like, the early Skylanders games? I don't remember. Okay, well, there's not a whole lot of people I recognize in this cast list. Okay, is there any other videos that we could watch? We saw the intro. Oh, I have to show you guys the blog post. That's right. That way we can really get a good words are hard today, I'm sorry. Let's read the blog post so we can get a good idea of what they're trying to fucking do with the Stream Master. Okay. So here we go. Crash Bandicoot N-Sane Trilogy first screens in depth details. This was by the game director himself, as you can read right there. So you guys can pause. I'm not going to read the whole thing off storybook style. You guys can read it right here. But one thing that I want to definitely highlight is this part here. For people... Fuck, I can't highlight. For people still thinking that this is a remake, they say right there at the bottom that Vicarious Visions is not considering this to be a remake. It's a remaster plus. So I didn't just make that up. I didn't make that term up. They're the ones themselves who said it. It's right there bolded for you. So it's a remaster plus, which means that they didn't want to, you know, as it says right there, we know how much you all love the original games, so we didn't want to fully remake them. So, remaster plus just means taking everything that was in the originals, keeping it true to that, but just making small tweaks here and there. Like the fact that you can do time trials in both Crash 1 now, as well as Crash 3, where you have to just kind of pause a little bit so you can, for those of you who want to keep up with the live stream, for those who are watching it live, then I'll give you guys some time to, read it. For those who might need a little bit more time, and you're watching this as a video, you can go ahead and pause it. As you can see right there, it says that we went further back to understand the material that originally inspired Naughty Dog, including Who Framed Roger Rabbit and Looney Tunes. So, they really are trying to stick true to the humor, to the animation style, and just to the wackiness. And so far, they're doing a really freaking good job. They're really trying to do their homework on Crash so they can get this right, and I love that they're doing that. And like I was saying earlier, with the way Crash looks and behaves in Skylanders, it's very much a reminder of Titans Men of Immune with him still battling and all that. It's meant to kind of keep that around a little bit longer, just so that way people can be like, oh yeah, is just total, that's Crash 1, that's the Crash 1 design of Crash, just redone with more detail. It looks fucking awesome. So, I think that's really cool. So, here's what they say now. Here are some work-in-progress examples of what to expect. Rebuilt levels based on the original geometry. So they're trying to, you know, again, keep true to the level design to a T. And they're rebuilding it from... Because it says here that... it says... What does it say? Okay, we'll get to that in a minute. They end up seeing at one point that they couldn't... The assets from the original game are, of course, fucking 20 years old. So they couldn't use those original... they couldn't use a good, like, good fucking portion of those original assets, but they're trying to do with what they can use and then just go from there. So, here's this. And, it looks really fucking good. So they're trying to keep true to the original level design, and they're going to keep it all exactly the same, just redone, more detail. From this screenshot alone, looks fucking beautiful. Now let's get to the cream of the crop, the character designs. Holy fucking shit. It looks fucking good. Really fucking good. We're, of course, missing some key people like Coco, Ripperoo, Dingodile, Tiny. Now, of the entire cast of 1, 2, and 3, obvious Hulk clone is obvious. Yeah, pretty much. It actually reminds me of, which is also still a Hulk reference, Plankton's, superhero body in the second SpongeBob film. His body's all huge and he just has like a little head. So that's pretty funny. This reminds me of for some reason. But that was pretty much what he looked like as well in the original game, so... God, I can't wait to see that boss fight as well. The only boss fight we've seen is Papu Papu's. So I'm wondering how all the other boss fights will look. They'll pretty much play the same way, but I want to see just how they look, you know? And hear the music and all that stuff. The Komodo Brothers look really cool. There's Pinstripe. Everyone just looks the same for the most part. It's really cool. Again, it's awesome how... Papu Papu has some extra tattoos and stuff that he just didn't have, you know, tribal markings he didn't have in the original game. But, you know, it's fine. Like, the way they redesigned him here is fine. He doesn't even look that fat. He's not really so much as fat, he's just portly, I guess. He just has a chubby belly. So that's pretty cool. Hold on. Gotta drink some water. Let's see. We got some stuff going on here. Oh shit, did the stream fuck up? I didn't even see that. From everything I was seeing, it was looking pretty good. My bad. If it's good now, let me know. Shit. I might have to go and fix it. I don't know. That happens every so often. Let's see. J-Dog says that Entropy looks a little weird. Yeah, he looks a little funky from the face. They also tinted his nose like a pinkish red color. It reminds me a lot of Megamind, actually, because if you look at the way he's designed, the way Megamind's designed, he also has a blue tone to his skin. His skin color is, like, blue. But to not just make him one solid color, just blue, they tinted, like, his ears, his nose, this kind of a pink color. And they're trying to... It looks like they're kind of trying to do the same thing with a similar thing, not like the same thing, but with Entropy right here. But he does look a little funky, I guess, from the face. Everything else on him looks pretty freaking good. Let me see, can I blow this image up? I think I can. Never mind. Let's go back down. Everyone else doesn't... They don't look that bad. Cortex looks very much like his Skylanders look. But more detailed, a little more original to this remaster. I don't have a lot of bad things to say about anyone here. They all look pretty good in my opinion. Let's see. Okay, everyone's... I'm trying to read comments. J-Bill says, I can't wait for a Tiny's redesign. Yeah. J-Bill says, Uka Uka's beard game is strong. Fuck. Hold on, I think the stream went out. God damn it. If it did, let me know, but, I think it did. Fuck. Fuck. Oh, is it good? Are we good? We're good. I think we're good. Sorry, the stream went out again for a little bit there. What's happening? Fan request. Yeah, so they're starting to actually, you know, listen. I want to see what things that they put in due to fan requests. So who knows what's going to happen. So let's see. They say unified checkpointing and save game system. So yes. They even go, yes, the first game now has a proper save game system. And then the menu system, which is pretty cool. So here's the pause menu, which looks fucking beautiful. Very, very reminiscent of... They're even shaped like the ones... Because those shapes for those gems in the first game never really came up again like that in the other Crash games. In 2 and 3 and onward. Well, mainly 2, 3, and Wrath of Cortex. They all had another... They were redesigned a little bit. The color gems were redesigned a little bit. But here, they kept the original shapes for those gems. Again, attention to detail, really cool. We also have the relics as well. There we go, time trials and all three trilogy. However, that's all we're going to share. Okay, here's a topic of discussion. What other new features could they be... set in stone that he's not going to be sliding and belly flopping. Okay, so that's all it says right there. Yeah, so that's the entire blog post. I just wanted you guys to really see that even they keep getting that question asked, so is this a remaster or a remake? And it's a remaster plus. It's not a remake, guys. So there we go. What else is there to really talk about besides just, like, getting, you know... I can't fucking think right now. I'm sick. I'm just getting over being sick, and I'm hyped. So those two things combined with me sounding like shit, I can't fucking think straight. I just want more. I want more trailers. I just want more. Are we? Oh, shit. Oh, the fucking... Did this stream go out again? God damn it. It probably is up again right now. Let's see. Luigi Gamer says, have Coco's gameplay for Wrath of Cortex for the first three games, but tweak her speed. Oh, like platform as Coco. That'd be cool, but again, there were no levels like that in Warped. What they've said for changes right now, so far, let me stress that, so far, they haven't alluded to completely new levels. Now, one thing that'd be cool, which I don't think I said before, or I might have said it in another video, I'm not sure. But one thing that would be cool is if they added in Stormy Ascent, or even finished the prototype levels from the first game, and included them somehow as like unlockable. But there was that. There was something else I was going to mention as well. I don't know, but that'd be kind of cool to see. And then Nat Kid says, I think the reset aspect on the boxes, if you lose a life, should be gone, honestly. Yeah, how in the first Crash game, they fixed it for 2 and 3, but in the first Crash game, if you die a good way to the level and you're going for the gem, breaking all the crates because they'll reset. And yeah, seeing as they're they're fixing the save system, and they're fixing... all that stuff with Crash 1, no doubt, seeing as they started to fix it in Crash 2, you couldn't see your total crate amount until the end of each level, but then in Crash 3, every time you just hit triangle to bring up the menu, you can see, the crate total. Yeah. Oh, the bag? Here you go, mother. Mother, I'm sick still. I sound like shit. Oh, don't need to take those? Okay. You realize you can just talk, right? Oh, but you don't want to? Oh, okay. That's cool. Everyone say hi to my mom. She's not going to reply back, though.
Hi!
So if they could fix all that stuff, no doubt they're going to fix it for Crash 1. I would bet.
Oh.
I would bet on it. What happened? Oh.
It flew out of the package.
Cool. Oh, geez, these are huge.
Here. Cool.
I don't remember them being that huge.
Well, that's what you're
thinking. Oh, I know, I'm just saying. Let's see, everyone's saying... Yeah, the recent unboxes has gone, they confirmed it, yeah. Slippery climb time trial equals hard mode. Exactly! I mentioned that in my second thoughts video. I'm like, guys, that level was hard for me to beat as a kid. Imagine fucking doing it for a time trial. Jesus. Yeah, let's see, hold up. Just drinking some more water. Taking some pills. Okay, let's see. Yeah, everyone's... Okay, yeah. So they haven't said a specific release date. It's just sometime next year. If you went on, like, GameStop's site to pre-order a physical copy, which I still have to do, or if you've pre-ordered it already digitally on the PS Store, they gave a really, really weird tentative release date of December 31st, 2017. I do not know right at all. That is completely 100% a placeholder date, because there's no way in hell they're going to make us wait that long to play this. Seeing as the first game looks like it's coming along really well, it might even be almost done at this point. Because that's the thing. Who knows how far into development the first game is around, and then they're still working on... They already confirmed, oh, we're still early into development with 2 and 3. So that's why they didn't want to... There's multiple reasons why they didn't want to show off 2 and 3, because they want us to stay hyped for it for when they do show it, and also because they're probably still working on it. So, I think that the first game is already coming along really well. It might be almost done already at this point. They just have to tweak some stuff around and do whatever else. But, with that being said, there's no way in fuck they're going to make us wait until December 31st of next year to play this. I highly, highly fucking doubt it. I don't know why they decided to put that as their placeholder. They probably just had to put a placeholder title or a date until, you know, we get the official one. I don't know why they just made that one the date. It's like, whatever. But my bet is still on... At the very, very latest, a summer release, or at a kind of earlier time next year, probably a spring release. Like, I could see it being in anywhere between March to May-ish. So, that's still pretty early-ish into the year, I guess. Well, that's like almost hitting mid-2017. But, like, I don't know. February 2017... It depends on how fast they work their asses off and, you know, hopefully they don't rush the game. It doesn't look like they're going to rush it. But February, everyone was saying February 28th, which is also the same date that Horizon Zero Dawn comes out. That seems a little too early at this point. Now that we're seeing and they're starting to talk about it now, like now that we've got, you know, Crash and Skylanders, and that's already happened, and now we're getting all this stuff, we can actually be here. And they're actually looking for feedback. So I encourage all of you guys not to, like, bombard them with requests necessarily and stuff, even though, like, they did say that they're looking at fan requests. But, like, I do encourage you guys to leave feedback to them, because they're looking for fan feedback. That's awesome. But, where was I going with this? I get into these little rambles, and I don't remember what I was saying previously. I'm fucking ready. I'm just hyped. shit. What do you guys think? I already asked you guys that, but you guys have been saying it's awesome. And it totally is awesome. Is there anything else we can totally look at real quick? Let's see. Nat Kid says that Knack seems so damn underrated. I haven't played all of it yet. I do have it. Because I played it at my friend Weston's house. Because he also has it. I liked it for what I've played of it so far. But I want to get my own PS4 so I can actually play it all the way through. You know, it's so funny how Knack 2 got released. Or released. Announced, rather. So I found that to be hilarious. Because everyone's been joking, like, well, what if there was an Act 2? Now there really is. So that's pretty funny. Let's see. What if they downgrade it to the Vita? Well, they haven't said that they would. And not that they're not going to, you never know, but they pretty much say it's exclusive to PS4, so I don't know. Let's see. Who else said it right now? Someone said. Oh, Luigi Gamer said, talk about PS All Stars 2. Well, the fact that it didn't happen at PSX. I still think that it could happen at some point. I mean, who knows? Who knows? But now that Crash is you know, relevant again, and, you know, people are doing stuff with them, if they ever make a sequel at some point to PS All-Stars, he has to be in it. He has to be in it this time. There's no excuse. So, him, and if they can find a way to get Spyro, then that would be awesome. But Crash, specifically, like, has to be in the sequel, if there's ever a sequel. Let's see. What is going on here? Is this something we already saw? Yeah. Okay, that's the comeback trailer. Oh, I know what we can watch real quick. Let me look it up. I was talking about it, but let's see that coverage again. Or, not again, but let's see that coverage from day 2 of PSX. So you guys, for those who might not have seen it, you can see it right now. Once I find it. Oh my god. Of all the symptoms of being sick, I fucking hate having a stuffy nose. Okay, Where is it? In the meantime, enjoy my little, my me. I can't say that, because I'm fucking stuffed up. Okay, I found it. Okay, here we go.
Welcome everyone to the PlayStation Livecast stage. I'm Meredith Molinari, and I'm super excited to talk about everyone's favorite marsupial, Crash Bandicoot.
Crash is back!
He's back! He's so hot right now, too.
He's totally hot right now. We saw him in, first we saw him in Skylanders Imaginators. Or somehow he got himself his own level. And I don't know if you know it, he was in the Netflix episode of Skylanders Academy. You know, somehow he got on set, and you know, he's got a guest appeared there.
He knows people.
He's crashing the party.
Okay. Right.
Anyway, so yeah. And then we saw him in Uncharted 4.
Yeah.
So
that was a cool little Easter egg.
He's letting us know that, you know, what's his 20th anniversary as well.
Yeah.
So he's letting us know that this is his.
Oh, also those fucking shirts. I want them.
When did the idea first come up?
By the way,
how long has this been in the works? Because I know people have been asking for it for a long time. So when
those shirts are awesome.
We have to bring Crash back.
Well, I mean, you know, that's true. You know, fans have been clamoring. We've all been clamoring for a while. And, you know, and You know, when you find out you're going to be working on such an iconic and beloved series of games, like especially the first three, which are arguably, again, the most iconic, beloved of the Crash Bandicoot franchise, you're just like, oh my god, what an amazing opportunity.
Is it a little scary? Because, I mean, there's a big legacy attached to Crash.
Oh yeah, it's a little scary, all right. Yeah, I think after the team started working on it for a bit, you know, once the rumors started going around and we hop on the message boards and then we see the YouTube videos of people like, oh, you totally need to put this in the game, I think it started to sink in a little bit.
Yeah. A little bit of pressure.
Yeah.
Yeah,
Yeah.
And we just knew we had to get this right.
PlayStation better fucking sell those shirts on the store, on their like online store. I want those both those fucking shirts. They look so cool.
I mean, it's a game that
they're simple, but they're cool.
Define what it means to be a PlayStation game. I mean, it's a game that defined a lot of kids' childhoods. So you know that's really important to us. We got to honor that.
Absolutely. Well, just from what we saw, we're talking about even just his eyebrows have so much detail. It's really a really rich version of the game. It's not just like, or at least to me, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, it doesn't look like, oh, we just took the levels and just made the graphics prettier. Like, this has actually been rebuilt from the ground up to make it glorious looking.
Yeah, no, that's exactly right. I mean, we consider it kind of like a AAA remaster. You know, the team really kind of approaches it like, you know, they would any other original title. It's getting that much love and care. You know, there's a lot of really good examples of that in the game. You know, you take a look at...
Here, you guys watch this. I'll be right back. I'm going to go do something really quick.
And then we start really building on top of it and adding all the personality and charm and lushness and detail that, you know, I think really the game deserves.
And music.
Yep.
Everyone was very excited to hear that music back.
Oh, yeah. Note by note, we're recreating this from the ground up. And, you know, like I said, like Don said... You know, the team is really, really passionate about getting this right and doing right by fans, so they're all in.
That's awesome. So we're actually going to be able to take a look at it.
Yeah, let's
today,
see
right?
some stuff.
Okay, cool.
Absolutely.
We'll take a look. So walk us through. So I know there's all three. We don't have time to look at all three of everything today.
Yeah, and things are still in development. So so what we wanted to show first was the intro cinematic. It's a great example of, like Dan said...
All right, I'm back.
How seriously we're taking this. We're treating it exactly like... You know, we win an original title. We've brought on our whole cinematics team. We have cinematics quality models and rigs. What that allows us to do is really sort of dial in on performance, facial performance, and just really bring out the personalities of these, you know, these characters that fans love so, so much. But really staying true to the original story.
Oh, yeah, and this was the first, when they officially showed off the intro. This was outside of God. Seeing as that's in HD, it looks super fucking good in HD. But they keep fucking talking over it, which pissed me off when I was watching it during PSX.
Absolutely gorgeous to look at. It's so vibrant. I mean, you talk about him being like a, you know, like this like crazy comic character, and there is a little bit of that, but it's like more 3D modeled version of him. You know, it's like every little bit of his fur is popping up, and all the other characters.
Yep.
Really wasn't just about him. The whole still can't find a shirt that fits him. That's really cool.
All right.
So we're gonna get into the first, which is Insanity Beach.
Yeah.
Take a look at first.
Yep.
Very cool.
So this is the first level of the first game. It's, you know, probably one of the most iconic levels, especially that first shot. And you know that, you know, speaking of music, the track from the first level, it's so sticky. I, you know, when we're working on
Nat could ask if Maurice LaMarche is voicing Embryo. Yes.
You know, it's, you know, just getting this right again was just really, really important to us.
So as you're playing through, I mean, you know, again, it's just the level of detail that we've been looking at here. I mean...
God, I don't even live that far from Anaheim, but, like, the chances of us going to PSX, because, trust me, I wanted to start planning a potential trip to PSX, and I don't live too terribly far from Anaheim. It's, like, it's a good 4-hour drive, you know, mind you, but, it's all about, oh, shit, oh, okay, it's all about, money, and, oh, geez, the letters are going through his face. It's all about the money and, you know, gas for driving to and from. This video keeps fucking pausing. Oh, shit. The video's gonna start pausing. Okay.
All the
here we go.
Lines and emotes and, you know,
with all that stuff in mind, the fact that, you know, it was going to be a family trip since my friends would have been busy during that weekend with just their own stuff, like with work and all that. God, this fucking video keeps... Okay, you know what? Let's just wait a minute for it to buffer or whatever. So with all of that being said, with my friends having their own stuff during that weekend, so there would have not been a chance for us to go. It would have had to have been a family trip, but yet my brother wouldn't be able to go because he's not 18, and you have to be 18 or over to go. So we couldn't do that. So there was really no way. And then like with me going by myself, like, I don't drive, so I'd have to fly over there, and I don't even know if I'm allowed to fly because I have, like, these heart issues and all that. I'd have to check with my cardiologist and all that stuff. There's just so much that was against me wanting to go to PSX, but if I did get to fucking go, Jesus, I would have lost my shit. Like, my reaction didn't seem that big. My reaction, I guess you can say, was, in fact, bigger when I, reacted to the first initial Crash reveal at E3, because I lost my shit. It was the first time we were seeing Crash outside of, you know, the Uncharted homage in some time, and so there was that. But then it didn't seem like I reacted too heavily or too big to this reveal for like the comeback trailer, but if I were there, as it happened, I was at the conference, I would have, like, lost my shit. Like, it would have been insane. And then I would have gotten to play it. And I'm serious. If I were there, if I had gone, I would have asked the guys, I would have asked Dan Tangway, however he pronounced his last name. I would have asked him if I had found him at some point during the conference. Oh, hey, I'm a YouTuber. Is it okay if we set up like a recording of the demo so I can play it, so I can cover it as coverage on my channel? Because I would have tested out everything, all the death animations, the game over screen, which I did eventually see the game over screen. It's nothing too impressive right now. It's a demo, very basic. Okay, if you guys haven't seen it, you know the loading screens with Aku floating around? It's just that, but it says game over. It's not anything too impressive right now. Of course, they're going to be redone. The loading screen will be redone, and the game over screen will be done when the official final game comes out. But besides that... Oh, thank you. But besides that... yeah, so I would have lost my shit, though. Like, I would have asked to cover the way a bunch of, like, Nukem Dukem and all them, how they all covered the footage. That'd be cool. So, let's see. Okay, it's buffered. Let's watch some more. Sound of attacking, shall we?
Pain, you can have a whole variation. I think almost all of the voice actors have been involved in the franchise at one time or another.
Yep.
So it's been really, and they had a lot of fun. They had a lot of fun doing this. It's so crazy too. Like 20 years later, you're like, hey, let me give you a call. I need you to come back and do it again. Yeah, they. That's so funny. This is the door. Yeah. So, obviously we've left no turtle unturned and make, you know. I'm sorry.
It's so easy. I know.
Crash is full of puns. So, but it's those kind of levels of details where, you know, we can just really have fun getting into those moments, which are just so delightful and, you know, what make this game so fun. And
yeah. Luigi Gamer says, what if they do reveal more stuff later, but at another convention? There aren't really any other upcoming conventions they could tease stuff at besides, like, E3. And I'm hoping that these remasters come out before E3.
Yeah.
Because, like I said, well...
We're going to ask them to try and go through it again.
Okay.
Yeah, no, I'm trying to think about it, and...
Oh, I hope he does. We'd love to see the... There's a really nice...
E3's in June, so...
But, yeah, we'll
see. I don't know. I mean, if there's a summer release, then they can show off something at E3. But I'm hoping at the very earliest it's like a spring release. Generally like just early to mid 2017. That's my bet.
Now it's really important Uh-oh, did he lose his mask?
He lost
his mask. Uh-oh. All right, well, we'll see.
Let's see if we can pull it off. Bigger challenge for him now.
But it's really important for us that, you know, this is a game for old and new fans alike.
Yeah.
And certainly with new fans, we've done a lot of things to make it even easier to pick up and play than before. You know, we've done a lot of work with the controls and the checkpointing and things like that. But we still want to make sure that there's that challenge there and that compulsion to go back and do more like
Absolutely.
We were talking about. So one of the things we added, which we think fans will be super excited about, is the fact that there's going to be time trials everywhere.
Oh, nice.
In all the levels instead of just in the third game. We don't
Did somebody sneeze?
Today, but tell you what, people have been working on it in the
I thought I heard someone sneeze.
They can't put it down.
That's awesome. Well, that's what I love, too. I mean, you talk about this is the 20th anniversary of Crash. You know, you only have to be 18 years old to be here at PSX. So I'm sure there are some people here that probably weren't even alive when the last
game came out. Dude Dog says, hashtag stop the turtle abuse.
Rediscover something they heard about growing up, where they were like,
oh, there. Bless you.
When I got into games,
now someone sneezed. My mom sneezed.
And now they get to like your folklore, like,
yep.
back out.
Yep.
And
that,
like,
that's really important.
Yeah, it doesn't help that they made them look a little cuter in this remaster with their faces.
Or now that you know
the little turtles.
Maybe my age or older, you may have kids and you're gonna get your kids into the game then.
The gym.
Yeah, it's a great game to pass around on the console and watch each other play, and he did it. He did it.
There's also a specific animation. There's also the again, cool attention to detail. There's a really cool thing where if you break all the crates but you don't collect the gem, it'll say great, but you didn't collect the gem, and he'll have like a mad face. He'll get mad at you. He'll look like right at you and get all angry. It's really funny.
That was one of the reasons we wanted to show it. I don't know if he's gonna make it through it all in time or not. But
I don't know. We doubted him last time, and then he showed up.
Yeah.
So we'll see. Now, this is a portion of what we actually saw in the. In the preview, in the showcase as well, right?
Yes. Absolutely.
Yeah, this is called a peasy.
Also, I don't know if you can hear that, but I'm eating mini M&M's.
Wow.
That's pretty impressive.
It tastes really good.
Another reason I like this level a lot is it's a great example of the level of detail and how we're modernizing these games.
You know, it's everybody that's seen this so far, all the fans that have seen this, are going, oh, it's heavy machinery. They recognize it right away. It instantly feels entirely familiar. Like, they know what this is. But you know, they're also starting to notice the level of care and attention and detail that's all been added new. Because, like, again, we're building this right from the ground up. You know, teams like, you know, all the rivets and the wheels and the pipes, and those are all new to this version. And
I won't even ask you how many hours you guys have already spent.
Dude, this makes me want to do the Crash live stream today.
It's been a few hours.
Yeah.
No, we're saving it for next week, though.
So, you notice he just picked up a token there.
Mm-hmm.
That's another thing that, you know, we've been really looking and paying attention to is bonus rounds. For the Crash fans and Crash 1...
I want to see someone... Rounds. No one...
They were cool.
See, I would have done this. If I were there playing the demo,
you know,
I would have beaten the entire Brio bonus round to see how that looks, because no one's done that yet, at least that I've seen. If any of you guys have a video on that, if any of you guys know of a video where someone who was there actually beat the Brio bonus round, let me know, because I haven't seen anything like that yet. No one's beaten the fucking Brio bonus round. Now, I want to see what it looks like remastered.
Absolutely. Well, it looks great. Continue focusing on this because I know all of us can't wait to get out there and play it. So thank you guys so much for joining us today.
You're welcome.
Yes, thank you for bringing.
Is Crash there a screenshot of Mad Crash? That was it. I don't know. You have to just look it up. I don't think there's a screenshot for it. Oh, let's see. In terms of videos and such that I wanted to go over with you guys, I think that's it. How long have we been going for? Because I didn't want to plan. I didn't plan for this to be like a super long live stream. Let me just see. I need the time over here. Okay, so it's been about almost two-ish, 2 hours-ish. I'm just reading some more comments real quick. Yeah, apparently you could hear me eating the... Yeah, I know you definitely could probably hear the M&Ms pouring out. I don't know if you could hear me chewing on them. Nat Kid says that no one's done it because they keep skipping over the secret area where you get the first Brio token. Which is true, yeah, everyone, no one really knows about that, or they've forgotten about it, so they've never tried to go down there. And again, it's a secret that I like, because it's like, why would you go down there? It's a gap. If platformers have taught you anything, gaps are bad. But that's one that you have to jump down if you want to get some extra boxes and the Brio bonus token. And what's crazy now is that both the Tana and the Brio bonus rounds, I'm not sure about the Cortex ones yet, because we've seen nothing about those. We know nothing about those as of right now for the remastered version of Crash 1. But, oh shit, did this fucking stream go out again? Before I continue that thought, hold on, let me check. Okay, no, we're still good. Let me see. Fuck, see, now I fucking forgot what I was talking about. Okay. So the boxes count now. The boxes in those bonus rounds, they count now, which is a thing that started in Crash 2 and 3. But now they've crossed that feature over to Crash 1, but the fucking Brio bonus rounds? Jesus. Those ones were pretty tough. Just, I wouldn't break all the boxes, because it's like, why would you need to do that? So that's the thing. CS Texas streams still up. I look at the quality and it dipped a little bit. So, let's see. Let's see, I'm just reading through some comments. J-Dog's like, yo, Mark, have you tried Marmite? It's like jam, you should eat a tub of it live. I've never even heard of Marmite. I don't have any. Oh my god. Let's see. Okay, what video was it, Luigi Gamer? Because I don't remember. Remind me in the chat. I'll see if I can find it. Oh, no! Fucking, I remember which one you're talking about. Because I saw it. I didn't call it out. I didn't call it out in the stream, but I know which one you're talking about. So if you guys are unaware of the fucking memes, like the B-movie memes and all that shit, well, now they've stretched out to a bunch of other ones. And the one that he mentioned, I actually did see a little bit of. We are number one, but every time they say, like, one or some shit, or every time they say something, it shows a crash death animation. Let's just keep it to N-Sane Trilogy footage for now. But, I've seen some of that. I definitely know what you're talking about. He says it right here. Yeah, we are number one, but every one is replaced by a crash death animation. God damn it. Oh, these fucking memes are stupid. Okay, so we're pretty much nearing the end of the stream. Let's just keep it right now to Crash N-Sane stuff. I am hyped. I, for one, am incredibly fucking hyped. I want to see what Crash 2 and 3 look like. No doubt they'll, you know, have, trailers all to their, all to themselves. And I'm really anxious to see what they look like, because I know that they're going to do them justice, and they're going to, you know, portray them faithfully. I just want to see what they look like. So, besides that, from what we've been shown so far, it looks fucking awesome. I definitely want to see more of Crash 1, just of the other levels and such. Like, we were going over what Hog Wild looks like from the comeback trailer, and what Temple Ruins looks like, and Lost City, Upstream. So, like, we got to see, like, Toxic Waste. We got to see a bunch of them. Cortex Power. So I'm hoping that, you know, hopefully at some point, maybe they will release a short demo to the public. Not the one at PSX where it was just the two levels and the intro, but maybe they'll have a few more levels, like at least 4 or 5 levels playable. Like Insanity Beach and Heavy Machinery can be 2 of the 5 or how many ever that they might want to put in a little demo, but hopefully they make the demo a bit longer with some extra levels in there, because that'd be, of course, fucking amazing to have. So I'm hoping that they consider that at some point. If there's any other questions you want to ask me about my thoughts and opinions on stuff, again, you can ask Q&A questions for my Q&A video that's going to go up in January, but I'm not going to answer them here. I'm going to answer them in that video. Just preface those kinds of questions by saying, oh, this is a Q&A question. So that way I don't answer it on stream. I can answer it in that video. Okay, so we've got some... Let me see. Bring some comments real quick. Nathaniel Foga. That's how you pronounce it. How well do you think this game will do? I think it'll do amazing because all of the older fans are going batshit over this. I'm really hoping, because it's really confirmed that every one of us who is an old school Crash fan, it's already bought. We've already bought it. A lot of us have already pre-ordered it, you know? And I'm going to pre-order it hopefully really soon. What I'm hoping, though, is that younger kids get to play and get excited for this Crash Remastered, because from what I saw, there were some kids that, you know, from some videos and such, before it was, like, officially out everywhere, when Skylanders Imaginators was, you know, still pretty much new, and they were showing off Crash and all that, there were some kids that were playing it, and they were playing as Crash and Cortex, and they seemed to enjoy themselves. So that's pretty cool. That's what we're hoping for, that the younger audience gets to enjoy playing as Crash and Cortex and Skylanders, and hopefully they'll get into playing Crash and N-Sane Trilogy, because it's wacky, it's cartoony, it's colorful, it's you know, got a certain kind of, you know, humor and all that stuff. It just screams something that, I don't know, any little kid can just get into. Like, sure, the old games are, you know, the original games are dated now in terms of, like, the actual graphics. Like the aesthetics and everything are not dated, just for seeing that it's a jungle and a temple, you know, jungle levels, temple levels, factory levels. Like, that doesn't scream, oh, you could only make a game with those kinds of aesthetics in the 90s. Like, no. The graphics are what are dated, because Crash looked more polygonal and all that stuff. That just makes sense, because that was, you know, Naughty Dog's first big budget game. But seeing as, you know, we've got this now with N-Sane Trilogy, like, it doesn't look like it even comes from a 90s game. It looks like if, you know, I don't even know. It looks so good, and it doesn't look dated. Like, Crash was never exactly dated, in a sense. So no one can really complain, like, oh, they're just bringing back 90s things for the nostalgia and for whatever. Like, no. It's to pay homage to where Crash got his roots from, and it still looks incredibly well done. The gameplay is not a strictly 90s thing, and the, you know, the aesthetics and the visuals are not 90s specific things. Like, that's just, no. If you think that's very close-minded, and that's very not right, for the most part. So, the graphics were the only thing that's really dead. Like, the music is still fine. It still holds up. Everything still holds up. So the fact that it looks this good now, too, for the fact that us as kids went batshit over these games back in the day, like, we were just super excited to play these games and we were having fun with these games, we can do that again with these remasters, and hopefully other kids can get into these games, too, because it's appealing. It's appealing to kids. Of course it is. Just look at it. So, let's see. Yeah, exactly. Nathaniel says, considering that Ratchet and Clank on, considering how well Ratchet and Clank on PS4 did, I know most likely it'll be a huge hit, proving to Sony that people want to see old PlayStation franchises come back. Exactly. Luigi Gamer says, after the N-Sane Trilogy ends, what will be next for our beloved Bandicoot? A new game? New death? I don't think so. I think that they might want to make a reboot, because that's what I was hoping for. I love it how, during, when I was, doing my huge-ass reaction to the Crash reveal for E3, and I was like, reboot, reboot, like, everyone in the comments kept saying, dude, that's not a reboot. They're going to remaster the games. I'm like, I know they're going to remaster them because I knew that. I was just hoping that they would announce a reboot. So now that I'm seeing the direction that they're trying to take Crash in, I get it. It's like, okay. So it started with, you know, him making an appearance. Naughty Dog, you know, included a Crash homage in Uncharted 4, which was really fucking cool. And that was to, like, just for nostalgic reasons, that was their way to pay homage to Crash for the 20th anniversary. Then, we've got Crash and Skylanders, that's just, you know, to, again, pay further homage, and to get ready, and get kids used to Crash, so that way when these remasters come out, now we've got this, the remasters, and the kids won't be, you know, the kids of today won't be, like, left in the dark as to who this character is and what's going on. They've already got some kind of a clue as to who he is and how he acts and all that stuff. And again, those kinds of kids won't exactly get all the references that were laid out in Skylanders. That was for us to pick up. But it's cool that they had those little references and stuff in there. But now they're going to be able to get used to Crash in, you know, these remastered games, and that's just cool. That's just really freaking cool. Sly Cooper! Yeah. What's up? Actually, Sly Cooper, we're already near the end of the live stream. I'm sorry. I think that happened to J Bills like a bunch of times from some of my previous live streams. Nathaniel asked what I think of the Ratchet and Clank movie. I actually did a video on it. I did a film reviews video. I reviewed it in video. Actually, that was during the time I had two copyright strikes. So I had to do it in multiple parts. So what would have taken me two videos took me like fucking five or some shit. I would definitely recommend checking back on my channel to see. They're in their own little playlist under Mark's Film Reviews. So definitely go and check that out. And that was good. I liked it. Let me see. Sly Cooper's like, oh, damn it. Let me see. Yeah, no, I think after the remasters come out, after N-Sane Trilogy comes out, I think they'll reboot Crash. And how they'll do that, again, who knows? And will it still be Vicarious Visions? Who knows? We'll have to see. Because I'm pretty sure the way this whole rights thing is happening, I think Activision was trying to seek out previous developers on the Crash series to find out who would be a good pick to remaster the original three games. For whatever reason, that Naughty Dog would not want to do it. I mean, their whole thing is, well, because of the games they're making now. They're very more mature for an older audience and whatnot. But, I've done some videos on that before, too, like, what if they came back to Crash and all that stuff. But see, guys, a lot of, there are still some people there that worked on, that work at Naughty Dog now, that did work on Crash, and that's, of course, pretty much why we got the Crash homage in Uncharted 4, because they probably went to those guys like, hey, we have an idea to put a Crash, a cool Crash Easter egg in there, help us to do that. yeah, I don't know, Vicarious Visions, was a really good pick, seeing as they just have such a huge, you know, respect and love for the series, and like I said before, outside of Naughty Dog, they have also worked on the franchise the most, the longest, with a bunch of games, a good 5 or so games, under their belt for Crash. So yeah, that's awesome. But I think that Activision was just trying to, like, because who knows, the people at Activision, like, who knows how their mindset was when they were trying to figure out how to do something for Crash. They figured they had to do something, so they were like, they were probably like, okay, well, who do we go to do this? Because we've already put our stamp on Minecraft Mutant, and now people, for whatever reason, are trying to blame us for that. So, they're like, okay, so who do we go to now? And they probably were like, well, Vicarious Visions, outside of Naughty Dog, has worked on Crash the most, so, let's try them. And it's like, of course they freaking, you know, wanted to do it. So, I think that's really cool. But the whole rights thing, like, so it's a partnership. Sony also said that they're partnering with that division as well to be able to bring Crash Remastered to the PS4 as an exclusive. So, who knows if Vicarious Visions will work on some kind of reboot or whatever they're going to do. All in due time. We just have to see how the freaking N-Sane Trilogy does first, and then we'll see what happens later. Okay, Luigi Gamer has to go. Alright, see you, bro. Yeah, Sly Cooper says, if you think about it, it was smart to get Crash exposure in Uncharted and Skylanders for marketing. Yeah, we've already speculated this a lot in the past. This was purely to get, Uncharted 4 being, again, for a more older audience, I guess. But to have that Crash homage in there, that was definitely to get us, the older gamers, to be like, oh shit, they're acknowledging Crash. Fuck, that's awesome. And it worked, just like that. A lot of people who did Let's Plays and stuff, when they got to that part, they were surprised, and they got really excited. So that was awesome. And then, to have Crash in Skylanders, initially we hated the idea. I hated the idea. We all admit it. You all hated the idea before we found out that this was the way they were going to do it. Once we found out, oh shit, this is how they're doing it, they're actually going to pay super careful attention and, you know, have attention to detail in this inclusion, then we were like, oh shit, okay, they're treating it with respect. Well, now it's not looking like a shitty idea anymore, and it's, you know, even I'm still trying to get used to the call him a Skylander, but his level, Thumbin' Wumpa Islands, looks amazing. They did such a good job on it, and it was really well handled. And him being in there along with Cortex is to get the younger kids, like I was saying earlier, affiliated with Crash and Cortex. That way, they could be like, oh, by the way, Crash has his own series of games. Here's remastered versions of the first three of them. And then, like I said earlier, the kids of today who don't really know Crash, even for as much as they know about him as Skylanders, they don't know much about his games, they can still jump into the remasters well enough because they know Crash from Skylanders. So, there's that. Let's see, more comments. Okay, not a whole lot of new comments. But yeah, guys, I think we're pretty much nearing the end of the live stream. Been going for about 2.5 hours at this point, I think. So, I'm ready. That's all I have to say. We're all ready. So, is there anything last minute? Not that I can think off the top of my head. I really wanted to bring some new stuff to this live stream. There's not a whole lot that was new that we talked about. So I guess we just have to wait and see whether they're going to post some new screenshots or release a new trailer. But I want to see Coco and Ripperoo and Diglett and Tiny. And I want to see more levels from... Because what other levels... Let's see. So we've seen the jungle levels with Insanity Beach. We've seen Jungle Rollers. And with that being said, like I was saying about the alternates, the other levels that share the same theme. If we've already seen Jungle Rollers, then we've basically already seen Rolling Stones as well. If we've seen Temple Ruins, then we've basically already seen Jaws of Darkness as well, because they all share the same look and theme. So we've already seen all of the jungle-themed levels. We've seen Heavy Machinery. And with that being said, Castle Machinery. We haven't seen The Lab. We haven't seen... Lights Out / Fumbling in the Dark. We haven't seen the generator room. How are the freaking Cortex faces going to look like on that? Because he just kind of weaved in and out of the screen awkwardly in the original game. So I wonder how... God, generator room is going to be so fucking creepy. Because it really was in the original game. Yeah, I want to hear the music in that level. I want to see what it's going to look like. And what Cortex will look like on the screens. We saw Toxic Waste. We saw Cortex Power just a little bit. I want to see all the boss fights. We haven't seen any other boss fight besides Papu Papu's. So, The Great Gate. We saw a little bit of that at one point. Just the tiniest bit. Yeah, so, oh, also, what is it, fuck, I'm forgetting the, Road to Nowhere, we haven't seen that yet. So there's a few levels we haven't seen. From the themes, like I was saying, we've seen a good portion of these levels. So, there's only a few more we haven't seen yet. I want to see everyone else's, all the other bosses, fights as well. I hope that they make some of these fights a little more challenging, like Papu Papu's. Should probably stay easy because it's just to ease you into the boss fights and all that. Ripper Ruse, for me, is pretty dang easy to get a hold of. Quella Kong's is a little bit tougher, I guess. It's easy. Like, for me, they're all easy because I know them. But if you want to really consider difficulty in the bosses from, like, a newcomer standpoint or something, I could see people tripping up on Quella Kong's boss fight. Pinstraps might not be that hard for a lot of people. Embryos, I don't really know. Again, it's pretty easy to grasp what you have to do, but in terms of doing it, I don't know if people have trouble beating Brio. Cortexes was easy in the original. I hope they make it a little bit harder in some way, somehow. Hopefully they can make his fight a little bit harder in the first game. Let me see to read some more comments. He says, "I really." Sly Cooper says, "I really hope they get John DiMaggio to be Tiny again." Yeah. Oh, and all the other Crash Car voice actors. John DiMaggio was a pretty okay Tiny. He was pretty good as Tiny. I could see them bringing back Quentin Flynn as Engine, because maybe if they want to keep a good, how many ever of the Radical voice actors they want to get back, seeing as they already got Maurice LaMarche, they got Lex Lang, and Jess Harnell, and Greg Eagles. No doubt there's still the strong possibility they'll have Nolan North voice Engine again. If they do, like Maurice LaMarche did, and even Lex Lang did with Cortex, and like Maurice LaMarche did with Brio, I'm hoping that if they do bring Nolan North back to voice Engine, I hope that he changes up his portrayal a little bit, because Brendan O'Brien's Engine was not that crazy, you know. Olinola North's engine was like super crazy, so he might still keep a little bit of that craziness, just to, you know, because that's how he portrays engine. But he's going to have to change his portrayal up just a little bit, be a little bit more sinister. The way Lex Lang is as Cortex in the intro, we already saw that the way he delivers those lines, he does it not in that flamboyant way, but in a more sinister way, which is awesome. So, yeah, because, I'm not shitting on Olin North for voicing Engine. Like, he was a really good, funny Engine. It's just that, from where the character started to where he ended up when Olin North voiced him, it's a different portrayal. So, Nolan North as crazy Engine is hilarious, but if he's going to do old school Engine, he's going to have to change it up a bit to match the older portrayal. The exact same way that Lex Lang dialed it down for this version of Cortex and Maurice LaMarche. Maurice LaMarche, god damn it, is redoing his portrayal for Brio. So, is there anyone else? Digo Dial, I don't know who they'll get to voice Digo Dial. I had said before that I wouldn't actually mind if William Hootkin's lines of dialogue were the only ones that they ripped back from the original Crash 3, because he actually passed away some time ago. So to pay homage to him as the very first Digo Dial voice actor, it'd be cool if they reused his lines of dialogue for Digo Dial in Crash Warped. That'd be cool. It's just like a in memory of kind of homage. If they don't do that, though, then I'm wondering who they'll get to voice Digo Dial. Because Olin North voiced Digo Dial in the DS version of Titans. And from the voice clips that I heard of him, from the clips I saw where he was there, he talked. Olin North didn't sound that bad as Digo Dial for the most part. I'm trying to think of all the other voice actors. Dwight Schultz was Digo Dial in Nitro Kart. He was okay. I'm forgetting who voiced him in Twin Sanity. I think it was not Quentin Flynn. I don't remember. But, yeah, I'm wondering who they'll get to voice Digo Dial. Let's see. Who else for voice actors am I thinking of? Entropy. I don't know who they'll get to voice him either. but yeah, okay, so we're pretty much done. I hope you guys enjoyed the live stream. I'm super fucking pumped for this remaster. I want to see more, and the minute we do get more, you can bet your ass I'm going to cover it on the channel in some way, shape, or form, be it reaction videos, be it discussion videos, you know, thoughts videos, or all of that combined, like I did already. You can totally bet that I'll be covering new footage, new screenshots, all kinds of stuff. So yeah, tune in next Sunday. I'm going to beat Crash 1 100%. I was originally going to do it today, but as you can fucking hear, I'm still trying to get over being sick, so I'm just going to do it next Sunday. Thanks, dude. CS Text is like, okay, thanks for streaming, but I get better soon. Yeah. I gotta fucking go to work tomorrow. I have to be all stuffed up. God. Okay, so I'll see you guys later. Let me know what you guys think about this, about all this stuff. I was gonna say in the comments. Well, I mean, you could. Since we're live streaming, you can just let me know right now. But, let me know, are you guys excited for the Crash 100% stream next Sunday? I'm just rambling at this point. I want to see more about Crash 2 and 3. That's definitely what I want to see more of. Okay, but that's pretty much it for the most part. So, thank you guys for tuning in. I'm Marcelo. I will see you guys later. Take care.